This is Linda Huang, Huang 老师. I'm your Chinese teacher. Welcome to my channel to learn Chinese with me. Okay, this lesson, we're going to continue to learn something about making a phone call. Okay, so how to answer a phone call? Just pick up the phone and say, 喂,你好. Yeah, you talk in person. Okay, so the word you can use, that is the way. Yeah, this character. The pronunciation is way. Way, 你好. Way. Okay, way. Yeah, way.喂，你好。喂，你好。Okay, 李老师在家吗？李老师 here means teacher Li, 李 yeah, 李老师 Li, which is a very common surname in China. Yeah, if you have some Chinese friendSurname is Li, don't be surprised because a lot of Chinese people have this surname, Li. Okay, 老师 means teacher. 李老师在家 at home. And ma, which is a question particle. Okay, so to help you read with pinyin, I can write the pinyin here. So, 李老师在家吗？李老师，李 ，yeah, which is a third tone. 老师 ，yeah, 老师 ，teacher. 我是老师，我是黄老师 ，yeah, I'm teacher 黄。我是黄老师，在 falling tone. Okay, falling. Yeah, let's make like a falling.Okay, 在 okay, 家 is a flat tone. 在家在 means at, 家 home. And ma is a neutral tone, which means to make a question. Okay, yeah, if you want to make a question, yeah, you just simply add ma in the end of sentence. 李老师在家吗? Yeah, teacher Li at home.Okay, how to answer? You can say 他不在家去学校了。Okay, 他不在家 So, 他 Yeah, he refers to 李老师 他不在家去学校了他 which is aflat tone, first tone, 不 is a rising tone because 在 is a falling tone. So, 不, yeah, actually this character, okay, 不, this character can change tones, yeah, depends on the next syllable. If the next syllable, yeah, is a falling tone, yeah, like 在 here, 在 is a falling tone,不 will change to a rising tone. So, 不在 Okay, 不在家 Yeah, not at home. 他不在家 She not at home. 去 means to go. Yeah, 去学校 Okay, go to school 了 Okay, here actually means yeah, went to school. She went to schoolOkay, so how do you know it's a past tense? Yeah, this 了 tells us it's a past tense. So, 去学校了 And for the verb itself, you don't have to do anything. Is that easy, right? In English, you need to change go to went. And in Chinese, you just say, yeah, 去学校了 Yeah, you can put 了 in the end of sentence or after the verb. 去了学校他去学校了 Okay.Yeah, now let's read. 喂，李老师在家吗？他不在家。 去学校了。 Okay, next sentence. Yeah, you start with Wei. Wei, 你是张小姐吗？ Okay, Wei. Yeah, that's how you talk. Wei, 你是张小姐吗？你是张小姐吗？ Okay, 你 certain 那一你是 yeah, this is a very interesting word. In English, it has the eight different forms. Yeah, to be. Yeah, M is are, was, were, been. Okay, have been. But in Chinese, yeah, we just use one form. Yeah, 是是 stays the same form. Yeah, all the time. You don't have to change at all. Okay, 你是 yeah, you are. 我是 I am. Yeah, 他是 she is, or she was, or he is, he was, or 你们是 yeah, you are. See, we don't have to change the verb form, right? Yeah, very easy. Chinese grammar is very easy. Okay, 你是张小姐。Okay, Zhang is another common surname in China. Yeah, even my mom's surname is Zhang as well. Okay, 小姐，小姐 means miss. Okay, 张小姐。Yeah, Miss Zhang. Yeah, 妈。Yeah, we mentioned it's a particle word we use in the end of sentence to make a statement convert to a question. Okay, 喂，你是张小姐吗？ You are Miss Zhang? 对。对对 which means correct, right? 您是 Yeah, if you want to know who are you, yeah, you can say 哦，你是谁 but it sounds very strong. Yeah, you can just say 啊，你是 or 您是 Yeah, because 您 is a polite form of you. So in this way, yeah, sounds much better.Okay, yeah, so you can just say 你是 or 您是 instead of 你是谁 right? Sound better. Okay, 对对的位对嗯对对 which means correct, right, yeah. 对对对 actually when we talk in real life, we say 对对对对对对 yeah, we like to duplicate some words, yeah. 对对对嗯好的好的好的是是是是是对对对您您您您您 yeah, 您是您是您 is a rising tone, 您是 okay, you can see the character 你 and 您 yeah, so for this 您 is the head, the heart, yeah, in the bottom, so which is a polite form you can use toYeah, talk with older people, with people with higher positions, with clients, use 您. Okay, yeah. 您是您是 you are. Okay, let's read one more time. 喂，你是张小姐吗？张 flat tone. Okay, 小 third tone, third tone. Yeah, it's like a V sign. Yeah.姐 also third tone, 你是张小姐吗? Yeah, you are Miss Zhang 吗? 对,您是 Yes, you are. Okay, next one. 喂,你在做什么呢? Okay, 你你在做什么呢? 你在做什么呢? Okay, 你 you在 yeah, 在 this word is interesting. Yeah, we just mentioned 在 here means at. Yeah, 在家 at home. And here, 在做什么? Okay, if we use 在 before a verb, yeah, here we change to the tense to the current tense. Yeah, so 你在做什么呢? So it's like to say, what are you doing? 你在做什么? 你在做什么呢?Okay, 做 means do. Okay, 什么 what? Do what? You do what? Okay, you are doing what? Okay, 呢 is also a particle word, question particle word we use in the end of sentence. 你在做什么？你在做什么呢？ Okay, 我在看书呢。我在看书呢。我 Yeah, to answer also easy. We just follow the same structure. Okay, 我 means I. 在看书。No, yeah, I am reading a book. So, 看 means see. Yeah, 看书 yeah, read a book. Yeah, because 书 means book. So, 看书 read a book. 我在看书呢。我在看书呢。Okay, yeah, let's see. Yeah, let's read this part. Okay, 喂，你在做什么呢？我在看书呢。Okay, so you know how to use the way and you know how to make phone call, right? Okay, now let's see next part. 我们看看下一部分。Yeah, we need to talk about the structure. Yeah, 在呢 yeah, indicate action in progress. Yeah, you can use 呢 in the end. Yeah, use 呢 in the end. You can also...Yeah, remove no problem. Okay, now let's see some examples. So for this structure, actually, it's very easy. Yeah, so first we need to know the verb. Okay, here, 睡觉 means sleep. And here, 我在睡觉. So if you want to say, I am sleeping, you just say 我在睡觉. Okay, 我在睡觉。我睡觉 means I sleep. Yeah, something in progress. Okay, 我在。Okay, I write everything here. 我在睡觉。我在睡觉。我在睡觉。我 I 在 falling tone 睡觉 sleep. 我在睡觉。Yeah, I am sleeping, doing something. Okay, next one, 做什么? Okay, 做 to do, 什么 what? Okay, 你在做什么呢? Okay, 你在做什么呢? Is a question. Okay, 做你在做什么呢? 什么做什么做什么你在做什么呢? Okay, next one, 小王 小, small, 王 is a very common surname in China. So 小王 little 王 If 小王 is younger than you, you can call him or her 小王 it's kind of a common in China. Some people might think it's not polite, okay.You need to make sure, if you are close or not. Yeah, if you are not close, don't call someone like this way. Okay, it might, make some confusion. Okay, you can, call the name directly and the proper way, especially in business scenarios, it's better to call the surname plus the job title. For example, how to call me? To call me,You know my job, right? I'm a teacher, so you can call me 黄老师. Okay, if you know someone is a doctor, okay, for example, 黄医生, so 黄 doctor. Okay, if you know someone is a lawyer, okay, 黄律师, 律师 means a lawyer. Okay, that is the very formal way to call people. Okay, how to address people, that is kind of important, I think, in any culture is important, right?Okay, 小王在做什么呢? Okay, 学习汉语。学习 means study. 学习汉语。You know, how to say Mandarin, 汉语。Okay, 学 is rising tone. 习 is also rising tone. 汉, means...汉 people, and 语 means language, okay? 学, this is yeah, U here, okay? But for GCC, yeah, when GCC follow U, yeah, we will remove two dots. Yeah, it looks like U, but it's not U, it's U. We read U, okay, say it with me. U, this is U, okay, and 学, 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 that is rising tone. So, 学习, 学习, rising tone, yeah, which means study, yeah, study, learn. 学习汉语, falling tone, third tone, 汉语, 汉语. For third tone, you need to start low, you go even lower, and then you go higher. Okay, say the 语 with me, 语, 语, okay, 汉语, 汉语. Yeah, because we are learning Mandarin, so you need to say Mandarin Chinese correctly, right? Yeah, 汉语, 汉语, Mandarin. Okay, study Mandarin, 学习, 学习汉语, 学习汉语. 小王在 学习汉语. Okay, you know how to use the word 在 to indicate the current tense, yeah, something in progress. Okay, now let's say, yeah, how to say the negative form. Okay, how to say the negative form? To say the negative form, yeah, we need to use this structure. We need to use 没. You can mention 在 and also the verb or verb phrases, okay? Now let's say, yeah, how to use it in the actual sentences. Okay, let's see some examples. Here, we can see, okay, if you want to say, yeah, I'm not watching TV, okay, how to say it? Okay, so I would say like this, 我没在看电视, or 我没看电视, yeah. For this word, 在 is optional. Okay, yeah, you can see it. You can, yeah, remove it. Okay, how do you say it? Yeah, 我, yeah, 我, 我, third tone, I, 我. Okay, remember the negative form? You need to say 没 or 没在, 没, 没 or 没在. 没 or 没在. Okay, and verb or verb phrases. So, watching TV, that is 看电视. 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 Watch TV. 看电视. Okay, 我没在看电视, or 我没看电视, 我没看电视. Okay, are you watching TV? How to ask? Yeah, 你在看电视吗? Okay, to answer, 我没在看电视, or 我没看电视. Easy, right? Okay, now let's continue. 他们, 他们, yeah, which means the, 他们. 他们. Okay, 他 is first tone. Yeah. If you want to change the plural to singular, from singular to plural, you just add 们, yeah, 们, neutral tone. Yeah, so, yeah, 他们, the, yeah, 你, you, 你们, yeah, the plural form of you, and 我, I, 我们, yeah, we. So you can see, yeah, very easy, right? Yeah, nothing else changed. Okay, 他们没在. Okay, 没在, 没在, or 没, 他们没在工作, 工作, 工作, yeah, work, 工作, 他们没在工作, 工作, 他们没在工作, they are not working, they are not working, 他们没工作, 他们没在工作, 没在工作. Here is better to use 没在工作, yeah, because if you say 他们没工作, it's, yeah, might cause confusion because here 工作 can be used as a noun. So 没工作 means don't have a job. Okay, here supposed to, yeah, to have a verb here. Okay, because 工作 also, yeah, you know the 工作 verb. Okay, 工作工作 yeah, 他们没工作没在工作 yeah, so it's different.Okay, next one. Let's say the verb first. Okay, the verb 看书 Okay, if I want to say, yeah, he is not reading a book. So I say 他没看书他没看书他没看书 So 他 you know, and 没 yeah, we need to use. And 看书 means read the book. So 他没看书看书看书 He is not reading a book. Yeah, that's a negative form. Okay, clear, guys? Yeah, let's read together to get familiar with these structures. Okay, yeah, first sentence 我没在看电视他们没在工作他没看书 Okay, clear?Okay, now let's read telephone numbers in Chinese. Okay, there's something we need to know. Yeah, before we read numbers, something important because for number one, yi, yeah, we don't read yi, we read yao, yi, ao, yao. Yeah, say it with me. Yao, yao. Okay.Yeah, and let's practice, okay? Yeah, so for Chinese numbers, also another thing, yeah, generally for telephone number, generally is seven digits or eight digits. If it's seven digits, you can pause here, here, okay? Yeah, first the three digits and then the last four digits. And for cell phone number, okay, you pause.The first three digits, and then, yeah, the second four digits, and then the last four digits. Okay, for phone number, telephone number, yeah, eight digits, you pause here. Okay, so every four digits, you pause. So it's kind of important because, you know, when you tell your number, you need to make other people to be clear, right? So that is way to make other people.People clear, so you pause, okay? Yeah, that is how we pause. Okay, now let's read this phone number. How to read? 八零六九四七八 Okay, repeat. 八零六九四七八 Clear?Okay, if you don't know how to read zero, okay, here's the pinyin of zero. 零零八零六九四七八 Okay, next one. Yeah, okay. Here how to read? Yeah, we read 幺幺 not 一 Okay, 幺幺幺三八五幺八九七六二三 One more time. 幺三八五幺八九七六二三 Next one, yeah, eight digits phone number, okay. 八二三零四幺五六 One more time. 八二三零四幺五六 Okay, now let's see some other phone numbers. Yeah, let's just practice more how to read numbers. Yeah, let me write some numbers. Okay, yeah, let's practice. For example, Okay, this is a telephone number. Yeah, how to read? So, yeah, first you say 八五九九 pause. Okay, here, yeah, 九九 some people like to say, okay, 两个九 okay, here, yeah, they may say 两个 lei ang liang, 两个九 okay, lei ang liang, 两 yeah, two, 两个九 two nine, yeah, they may say it like this way, 两个九 ji o 九八五九九呀，八五两个九，六七三幺。OK， 八五九九，六七三幺。OK， remember to pause. OK， OK， now let's see another number. OK， for this phone number, let's read together. 幺三八。幺三八，幺三八 ，pause 九零零零。Okay, here you can see there are three zeros. Some people they may say like this way. Yeah, 三个零。So if there's three something, you say 三个。Yeah, just like, what we say in this way, 两个 and here 三个。三个三个零三个零三个零三个零五六九八三个零五六九八 OK, one more time 幺三八九零零零五六九八 or 幺三八九三个零五六九八Clear? Okay, and how to ask, yeah, what is your phone number? Okay, what's your phone number? Yeah, 你的电话你的电话号码是多少 Okay, 你的电话号码是多少你 you, 你的 means your, 电话电话 telephone,号码号码 is optional. Yeah, if you want, you don't have to say it. Yeah, okay, you just simply say, 你的电话是多少？你的电话是多少 ？Yeah, is what? Is how much? Okay. And here, 电话 telephone. Yeah, if you want to specifically mean that you want to ask for the cell phone number, you can say 手机。Okay, 手机手机 yeah, cell phone. What is 手机？这是手机，手机，手机。对，这是我的手机。对，你的手机 yeah, your cell phone. Yeah, 你的手机是多少？你的手机号码是多少？ Yeah, and then you just tell the phone number, your cell phone number directly.Okay, there are some details you need to pay attention. Okay, 一 not 一 一 you need to read 幺 Okay, 幺 and especially Chinese phone numbers start with 幺 Okay, 幺三九九零零零五六九八 or 幺三哦幺三八九三个零五六九八 Okay, clear guys. Today's lesson kind of important, right?Yeah, something basic about ask for phone number. And when you hear the number, you need to write it down. Yeah, just practice. Yeah, listening and practice. And then check if you're doing correctly or not. Okay, any questions? 有没有问题, guys? 有没有问题? Let me see if you have any questions. 让我看看你们有没有问题。Yeah, so do you guys think Chinese is easy to learn? 你们觉得中文好学吗? Easier than English or your own language or some other languages? Yeah, in my opinion, for grammar in Chinese, it's quite easy. Yeah, because we just have very streamlined grammar rules. Yeah, everything's very clear. We don't have complicated rules. Yeah, no need. Right? Okay. Yeah, and for a telephone number, you guys really need to pay attention and spend time, especially for the accuracy and the accuracy. Okay, and I would like to let you guys know that if you want to add my WeChat, here is my WeChat code. We just mentioned how to ask for phone number. Actually, how to ask WeChat account is kind of more important. So how to ask your phone number. Which one do you think is more important in your country? When you want to contact someone, do you ask phone number or do you ask for the WeChat or some other social media account? Just let me know, okay? Because in China, absolute people will ask WeChat, maybe only WeChat. We don't even do the business card. I think that is kind of out, very, very traditionally. Nowadays, people only use WeChat. So WeChat is important. You guys need to have a WeChat if you don't have a WeChat. You need to download one, create an account, and add me as a friend, okay? 加我微信。You can ask, 可以加你微信吗？ 你的微信号是什么？ 你的微信号是多少？ Okay, like this way. So you guys are connected, really connected. If you only have a cell phone number, maybe you never call, and then you forgot. It's very easy to forget. Okay, so it's better have a WeChat. Okay, 微信. And the right side is my WeChat account. 右边是我的微信号。左边是我的微信视频号。And left side is my WeChat channel. And also would like to announce that I'm going to start beginner Chinese class in September. It will have 5 hours per week, 4 weeks, 20 hours in total, and it's online live stream class. So it's not live stream like this. The live stream with me in a small group, and you will have a lot of chance to practice, to interactive with me, and you also have the chance to get your pronunciation corrected, also have a chance to do the role play and create dialogues and a lot of exercises with me. Okay, and for the course outline, we're going to use 4 weeks to learn something, basic, something very important, like pinyin, tones, and also the basic conversational skills like everyday phrases, ordering food, zodiac and culture, daily activities, and so on. Okay, and for the price, that is $99, okay, for 20 hours. Okay, let me know. Okay, if you guys are interested in learning with me, okay, and if you really want to improve your Chinese, just let me know. Okay, I will always be here, help you to speak Chinese confidently. Okay, thanks for watching. Thanks for joining my live stream. I'm going to see you guys tomorrow. 明天见, 谢谢,再见。明天见,再见。再见,再见,明天见。明天见,再见,谢谢。谢谢。 谢谢你们，谢谢 Nicola， 谢谢 Erica， 谢谢，再见。